Welcome to section 6, using a pool of workers. In this section, we will learn about using a pool of workers for maximizing usage of hardware, when and how to use a pool of workers, and good practices and anti-patterns when using a pool of workers. Use of pool of workers for maximizing usage of hardware. In this video, we are going to first look into a real-world example of using the multiprocessing module, then look into the constraints, well, if you can call them so, that the multiprocessing module can impose, and finally, see what can help us overcome those. Let's get into the demo straight away. The demo program used here uses the Python's PIL module to create thumbnail of images, especially the JPEG ones. If this program doesn't work for you, make sure you install the pillow module as specified here, that is using pip install pillow. If you look at the program, what it does is simple. The program goes through a list of JPEG files from one of the folders and then creates a thumbnail for each of these images using a worker method called as create thumbnail. This has a real world use case in the photo viewer applications. However, be aware that the code here to create thumbnails is not production ready and can create thumbnails of resolution 128x128 only. This is a program that executes in one Python process. That is, only one process handles the thumbnail generation process for all the JPEG images one after the other. What this means is, though there are multiple CPU cores available to be used parallelly, we used only one of them. Just before the demo, I ran this program on my box. And this is the output, and you can see that it took close to 53 seconds to complete while traversing over a folder which had 1000 JPEG images. To speed up the process, we can parallelize the thumbnail creation using multiprocessing module, where multiple processors can generate thumbnails simultaneously and independently for different files by calling the generate thumbnail function. However, like in this case, where the number of image files is over 1000, it would mean that many number of processors running almost at the same time, and I did not dare to attempt this on my machine. That is because processors are inherently heavyweight and require a lot of OS resources. And each process that we create using the multiprocessing process class would be one full Python interpreter process. And that is performing just one simple task of generating a thumbnail. This would put so much load on the operating system to run 1000 processors. And given the number of processor cores available, which is 4 in this case, which is much less than the number of files that we are trying to generate thumbnails on, this could be totally counterproductive. We have to devise a way to maximize the usage of CPU cores without heating them up too much. So what I have done is I have created another program here. This program splits the number of image files rather equally on all the processor cores, which is got using the multiprocessing module's CPU underscore count method. I have done this because theoretically, there is no point in having an expectation that the number of processors that my machine can run simultaneously be greater than the number of CPUs available. If you run this program, of course, there will be an improvement in the time taken to create thumbnails for the same 1000 images. And we would have put all the CPU cores to use at the same time. Well, at least theoretically. However, if you look at the program closely, it is also performing the task of splitting up the image files across processors. That is, it is basically splitting the work between the various processors. This is a simple scenario. However, there can be complex cases where we might have to perform even more. That is, we might have to have some kind of communication between these processors, like retaining a value from a worker to the main program. It is not difficult to implement a basic series of communicating processors, but it can be tricky to debug and test. And Python, being Python, we don't have to do all of this work because the Python developers have already done it for us in the form of multiprocessing pools. And I'll explain what multiprocessing pool and how to use it in the next video. Concluding the video, we took a peek into the real world example of using multiprocessing module, then understood the constraints of multiprocessing module if not used properly. And finally, we saw that multiprocessing supports something called as pools, that can help us maximize the usage of hardware.